Hello, fellow chummers! Welcome back to Shadowrun Returns! This is Archangel TJ, your gamer girl, signing in. And joining me on the run, we have Stacy.
Howdy-ho.
And I think Dodger.
I'm kinda here, kinda not.
Okay, so kinda Dodger. So, in the last episode, we dealt with, we were able to gain the Aegis Project, which will help us against these bugs. And now we are about to fight said bugs. So let's get this started, shall we?
Da-da-da-da. And it's dark. Great way to start the battle, man.
I was about to say, should I just have you as no, not gonna happen? Ow. Where do you think you're going?
Yeah, I might have to do screen share again. Mm-hmm. Screen share expired. Thank you.
Mm-hmm. You stay away from Coyote. I won't allow it.
At least you're not missing.
Denied.
Yay.
I raised my melee, so...
So you can't miss? Thank goodness.
There's at least a better chance of hitting.
That's good. Because I remember the first time you couldn't hit with shins, and it was really infuriating. You were like, God, why? They're right
even,
in front of...
Even for you, who... isn't even playing the game.
Yes. Well,
it's
as
like,
a spectator,
how can you miss that?
Yes. As a spectator, it's really infuriating because you're like, why can't you hit at point blank range? It's like your whole crew missing with their guns at point blank range. It's like, how do you miss that?
Flanked anyway. Right. What are we dealing with here?
At the end of the dark, dark hallway. Somebody want to throw a flashlight? Oh, darn.
Oh, you son of a bitch. That's it. Shotgun in the face for you.
A shotgun?
Well, technically.
Okay. Well, oh.
Where do you guys think you're going?
They're leading you to some place far and dangerous. Don't know if you want to follow them, but then again, since it's video games and video game logic says, go for the stupid decision.
The stupid decision is the only way to go.
Yes, I know, that's why I'm like, because I'm saying, video game logic. You know it's a bad idea, but because it's the only way to progress the story, you have to go with the stupid idea. So, if it's stupid, go for it. Sorry, y'all, but let's be real.
Getting away from me that easily. Hi! Fuck you all.
I love you too. Is that flesh on the wall? Nah, it's too much.
Come on, take it like a man.
Well, they are taking it, and they're still standing, so...
I mean it in the way that says, don't fucking run.
Yeah, well. If they're smart, they're not going to take it, because that means
hi,
they'll die.
There's a bug here.
Ew, creepy valley. So that explains the dirt hill.
This is what I think about your fucking true form bugs.
Need the exterminator?
Damn, you are one tough bug.
Well,
Come on. Really?
We're taking a mighty long time to kill these things.
Coyote? Coyote? Oh my god, Coyote, really?
Oh gosh, it was not you missing with your club, it's somebody missing with their guns again.
Are you that bad?
Apparently.
There we go. There we go. Okay.
Well, you can't miss it, it's really bright. At least I hope you can't miss it. Only two more things to kill in this room. At least I think it's only two.
There.
One more thing. Now we drop a lock, Nas! And you missed.
Jeez, people, you need to learn how to aim!
Tell me about it.
Oh my god! Again, I'm not the one playing this game, but oh my god, really, why do you do this? At least they're squishy. But, jeez.
The bugs are the hard one.
Yes, they're squishy and all, but if you can't hit them, what's the point of
them? Oh my god, he's got an accuracy spell.
I say we utilize that now. Especially for Coyote with her shotgun. It is a shotgun, right?
Yes, it's a shotgun.
Okay, because at least when I was looking at the gun. It's a grape shot, but you don't know.
Reload. Don't want to go in there with little to no ammo.
Sounds like a plan.
Hi! I'm not even gonna.
Hello there.
Oh, hi, so you come to me. Cool.
Okay.
Whoops!
And
well,
you.
There was stupidity number one.
What did you?
I used the weapon for the bugs.
Okay. Yeah, I don't think bug spray's gonna really kill a person. At least not in that small dose.
It's big enough to kill the bug spirits.
Yes, but it's bug spirits. They're not exactly bugs, nor are they spirits.
Alright, there's gotta be more in here.
Of course! There's always more.
See? What'd I tell you? There's more. Really?
My gosh, your entire group is a poor shot.
Where are you going? You won't be crawling out of here.
At least we hope not. Well, go and squish it.
Working on it. At least I would. Oh! There were two doors.
Oh, went out the other. Where's it going?
Oh.
Oh, there's a second bug. Okay.
Accuracy on you. Really?
Well, apparently your entire team is a poor shot. So you might have to.
Ooh, 30 damage. Nice, Coyote.
After she finally hits, hallelujah.
Lol. I get it.
Well, you have to admit that was rather painful.
There it is. God almighty. Coyote? Kill yourself. And I think our other friend just went back into his body.
Body snatching, are we? No, he's not body snatching. He's, what, feeding into his shell? Jeez.
One down. One more to go. As soon as we can get rid of the body again.
Oh, jeez. Set the body on fire?
We didn't start the fire. Damn it! Oh my god, that doesn't help. I hate that this stings. Coyote?
Please don't miss. Thank you.
I'm not fond that this thing is only two bullets.
Only two shots per?
Yeah.
Well, it is a shot. If it's like a shotgun, yeah, it makes sense.
That don't mean I'm not fond of it.
Yeah, that is true, but unfortunately it makes sense. Oh, is that a dead body? Or is that a dead or is that a carcass of a spider thingy?
I am. Can't not tell. Sure.
Can't tell, that little icon's over it, and it's blurry on my screen. Hold on. Ah!
Pile of broken bodies.
Oh, it's a pile of broken...
twisted and their jaws hang open seemingly in terror.
Oh, so it's a giant... it's an amalgam of bodies. Never mind! Okay. How many more of those are you gonna find?
I'm technically going into their hive, so.
So you're gonna find more of those little body pellets.
Most likely. More or less.
Have fun.
Oh, hello. Lord, you guys are in an interesting place. Haha. Bitch! be really surprised if... There you are! There they are.
Well, hi there, buddy. Gee.
Gee willikers. There's one.
One squishy down.
Ooh. Coyote. Do me please a favor, hun.
If you miss with a grenade, I will be so disappointed.
It got one.
Only one? Well, beggars can't be choosers. At least I didn't miss. And missed.
Can't be easy when it comes to her positioning, you know?
Yeah, that
I should
is...
probably get rid of you.
Get rid of the squishy. Alright, apparently they're not that squishy. Dang.
This team!
Oh my god. Yeah, okay, good. Go towards Coyote. Harlequin, are you gonna be okay? No, you are not. Please, heal yourself.
Who's Coyote?
A party member.
It's
no, I can't see anything right.
Yeah. Coyote's a girl. She's one of my members. Hit him! Thank you!
10 damage. Woo.
God, you are taking forever to kill.
Guess he ain't so squishy after all.
Alright, I should get prepared with him. Well, actually... Why is there... Oh my god. Really?
It's an ambush! Well, not really, because they haven't actually hit you yet. And you still see them. Coyote. Apparently you found your sweet spot in terms of accuracy. Hopefully it stays like that.
Yeah, really.
Knock on wood.
Is it running away? Really?
Well, I guess it's smart. Unless it's gonna go pull you and lure you to an army of them. Yeah, it would be smart then.
Another one down.
Another one bites the dust.
Why did you do that automatically? Oh, whatever. Hi. That leads to an actual place. Everyone follow Coyote.
Unless it's a box. But we'll see.
Well, it looks like it leads to an actual hallway.
Yes, but I'm just wondering if it circles around that hallway that you're looking at. Oh, wait, no, the door's closed. Yeah, I go that way.
Really? Thank you. Really good at dodging that.
Jeez.
There we go. I take no chances. This is the best I've ever done on this game. Mostly because I have something to actually freaking fight these things, so.
Alright, everyone, move forward.
Definitely looks like I'm
heading to the center of the hive. Good job.
We continue on down into the belly of the beast. You enjoying this?
Clearly.
Oh no! Perhaps you should construct an epic poem about our adventure here.
Oh, be our bard.
It would not have been the first written about me, to be sure. I shall consider it. Now onward! You hear himself muttering rhymes to himself as he walks. Okay, dude, I like you. I really like you.
You have your own bard with you, Nas.
You are? I was wondering when I'd find one of you. Come here. Hi. How you doing?
Well, hi-ho. We gotta switch gears.
Yep. Whoops. Oh, shit balls. Goes that one.
Okay.
There's another one down.
Another one bites the dust.
Where do you think you're going?
Crawling away. And yeah, missed. Gee, this track record. Ah, jeez.
Really?
But of course.
Another one gone. Can only imagine how many more are in this place. You're just asking for trouble, ain't you? You just hit your own person! Forward, you can run far. Really? I'm not in the mood for that. That mage gotta go. Holy shitballs! I honestly did not expect her to kill it in one hit after that. One down. Oh my God. Bombardier has to go. His own buddy. Idiot. bombardier one definitely has to go. Oh, come on. Thank God. Oh, hi. Ah! here has good decking? Are you a decker? No, you're not. How's your decking skills? Well, shit. Door's unlocked. Okay. We're getting somewhere. With that? At least you picked up some med kits and whatnot. That's all I really care about. We're definitely not going to be able to get what's in that safe. Probably should have brought a decker. Oh well. Too late for regrets. The bug shaman. Oh, so we're actually gonna fight the bitch herself, if it's a bitch. Right. Yes, please, I have some karma. Right, okay. Yes, definitely. I want no regrets. Okay, only one door to open. There you two are! Jessica appears to be in the throes of a violent rage, or mid-seizure, a manic state brought on by the terrible energy she is attempting to conduct. TJ, stop! The Queen approaches! The vessel, summoning, we cannot be disturbed! There is no vessel and there will be no Queen! Jessica's eyes roll back in her head. Whatever magic she is channeling is fast approaching a crescendo. Lynn speaks in her place. You may have taken Marie Louise, our chosen, but another Telestrian will take her place. I give myself willingly. I will be host to our queen, and the mother of a new world. You've seen what these things do, Lynn. This queen will devour you, body and soul. Harlequin makes an exaggerated grimace, and then crap out a few billion yen. Ugh. No. I will become a perfect being. Through me and through my sacrifice, a new age will begin. When Jessica speaks this, her eyes are of a disturbing sharpness. Her words are echoed by Lynn in a manner that suggests a connection beyond their shared zealotry. The hive has no thought beyond hunger, no goal beyond reproduction. Reproduction, what the fuck? We are one. Sam had a hunger too, didn't he, Jessica? This seems to throw her off. What? You said it yourself. Sam had appetites. All that mattered to him was his next fix. Vile appetites. Appetites he couldn't control, and he died for them. Because I willed it. Yes, but why? There was more to it than just your mother. The hum of magical energy permeated the room seems to quiet. She's listening. You came under the thrall of these creatures long before you knew of your mother's death. The Brotherhood, they were a family to me. Yes, and they had already freed you from your old life. So why come back? Why kill Sam? I had to do it for what he did, for what he had become. You said Sam represented a sickness in your world, but I think he represented the sickness in you. You're trying to confuse me. You saw a rawness in yourself, and you projected it onto Sam. No, He was your brother, Jessica. Your twin. Don't you see? Jessica falls quiet. She bows her head. I'm sorry. But there's no turning back. I cannot undo what's been done. And I can't stop what's to come. Jessica's body then suddenly spasms. Arcing her back. And nearly lifting her off her feet. She lets loose a scream, falling somewhere between elation and agony. The queen is near! Wait, am I not supposed to attack her? Will it take this? No. Shit. Wait, what is that? Another insect pillar. Drawing power from that thing. Yeah, no shit. Thank you. I figured something bad was going to happen with that. Bitch. Great. Now bomb deer too. Then it never is it? tried to talk sense into you. This is the fate you've chosen. Any chance you had of surviving, Jessica, you wrecked. Shit. I've gotta get rid of that bombardier. And more bugs. Jessica's almost done. Good. There will be no queen. Here. What are we gonna do about Linda? Loaded and I had the chance. That's one down. Okay. Why did you just go? Okay, well, whatever floats your boat there, buddy boy. There's another one down here. Could you not? Another one down. Come on over, Coyote. Have some fun. Ow. Sorry, am I standing on your body? Whatever works. Is that all of them? Is there more? Once beautiful Jessica Watts is a hollow shell of her former self. Her skin is pale, her lips are ashen, and her eyes are sunken in her skull. It is more than her body's reaction to the physical damage she sustained, or the strain of channeling magical power from another plane of existence. There's something missing from her now. It's gone. My link to the Queen. She's abandoned me. Expelled me. Unworthy. Unworthy. It had to be done. The nest would have overrun the city if we hadn't stopped you. She shakes her head weakly, her body slumped as if it might fold itself into the ground. You don't understand. There are nests everywhere, in every major city. It's only a matter of time. Oh God, what have I done? Sam. I'm so sorry, Sam. Please, Archangel TT, don't let them need me. Death would be too quick a punishment. You're going to pay for what you've done. She lowers her head in shame. I understand. Why do I have a feeling that this isn't actually the end? And after we broke up the ritual, Archangel TJ chased Jessica into a small chamber where she was cornered by a couple of bugs. Guess they weren't impressed by their performance. They were about to eat her. And? And Archangel TJ says something like, I won't let them eat you, Jessica. You're coming with me. You're going to pay for what you've done. It was very dramatic. Then we splattered the bugs and handed her over to the UCAS FBI. They're going to want to have a long talk with her about the Universal Brotherhood. So this nest is cleaned out, and your cousin Lynn is being transported to a mental hospital for observation. James assesses you with a newfound respect. Very clean. And I believe our test of Project A was a success. Archangel TJ, Arabraka is having it weaponized now for distribution to errant night forces. The authorities are going to have a great many questions about this incident, and I will need to provide details. The Universal Brotherhood has a great many chapter houses, and they must be dealt with immediately. What will happen next? That is for others to determine, people other than you. Still, you have turned a yeoman's effort, and regardless of your obvious flaws, you are deserving of a reward. What would you like to ask of me? I hear you have an opening for a new VP of security. Telestrian regards you for a moment. He seems to be choosing his words. Unfortunately, an orc is not an appropriate fit for Telestrian Industries Corporation Executive. I'm sure you understand. However, I believe whomever fills this position will benefit from an executive consultant of your caliber. The position will pay quite handsomely, and I assure you. Report to work on Monday. Just do something more appropriate. Good day. Sheesh, 20 karma. Let's see where I can put that shit. There we go. Guess that's it, huh? You captured Sam's killer and now he'll get his justice. Guess so. Tough week, huh? Gainers, hellhounds, a muck mental patient, serial killers, ghouls, corporate deckers, extra dimensional bugs, and an army of core security. Yeah, I could use a nap. I bet. Coyote Greens, first time. Well, I'm gonna grab Paco, head back to the Union, maybe watch a trade or something. I could use a long shower, too. After that. You could learn the business, take over for Miss Kubota someday. She gets a twinkle in her eye. Someday, maybe. When the rest of my body is made of metal, too, but not today. Today, I run the shadows, get paid, get dirty. See you around, Archangel TJ. You're quite a lady. I can honestly say I've never met an orc quite like you. The painted elf is watching the scene unfolding around the Universal Brotherhood with a grimace. Well, my kid, it's been fun, but I've seen everything I care to see today. I'm gonna get out of here. Where's our practice? Is there a problem? He gestures around at the crowd as he speaks. Look around. Not the member of press being shuffled away by Universal Brotherhood spokespeople to get a private briefing. Brotherhood is connected. Damage control team is probably on the way now. They think they can really control the press? One way or another, they will. If it can't be manipulated, coerced, or bribed, they'll probably disappear. Quietly. There's more, though. He nods his head towards James Telestrian. Note the expression on the UCAS FBI agent speaking to Telestrian. Dismissive, isn't it? That's because there's no love lost between the UCAS and Tarangir. They're not going to trust what he's telling them. And frankly, I have no idea what he's telling them. James plays his own games. Always. Do you trust him? No. Just like I don't trust you. But don't take it personally, Kate. You shouldn't trust me either. I've been manipulating runners like you for years. I'm manipulating you right now. You just don't know my game yet. Let's continue the dance. I have one more to show you. He points at someone in the crowd and smiles. The man sees him pointing and smiles back. That guy there? It's with Eris macro technology. Enormous megacorp, ridiculously powerful. They've been sniffing around Project Aegis for quite a while now. Clearly, they have an agenda that's just starting to unfold. He gives the heirs man the finger. The man smiles and returns the gesture. Government, media, business, all working to ensure the truth stays hidden. Not from me. No, not from you. You're a runner. That's the idea. But it's not the giant machination it appears to be. In a way, it's worse. It's a series of conspiracies, conflicting agendas, and petty jealousies. All building upon, feeding upon, and excreting up into an unending web of dreck that people wade through every day and call it life. If there was one Dark Lord controlling everything, and we could drive a magic sword through his heart to free the world, that would be grand. Such clarity, such focus. Alas. So what's listening to all this? That I did all of it for nothing? Just the opposite, schmuck. The lesson is this. The game is rigged, the cards are stacked, the dice is loaded. It's the same as it always was. Every cycle, people in power exert power. Little people cower in their homes, think what they're told to think, and buy whatever product will help them forget how horrible their lives are for another day. And that's why we don't play their fragging game. We don't swallow their dreck sandwich and politely ask for another. It's why we run the shadows. That's where real life is, kiddo. Reality is living in the places no one wants you to see. Where's Eric Brackus? I thought he'd be here, too. He flew back to Berlin. All sorts of things brewing there. He was very impressed with you, though. It could probably turn into work someday. But I'd forget about him if I were you. Never make a deal with a dragon kid. They're playing a different game entirely. Okay, seriously, who are you? A friend. Until I need you for something, then I'm a bastard. See you around, Harlequin. What are you looking at, Choop? Oh, jeez. I've been wanting to do this. I am a happy orc. I've been wanting to do this for the entire game! Hey, Archangel TJ. I was wondering if I was going to see you again. I guess I shouldn't be surprised to find you here. Hello, Dresden. How's my favorite body snatcher? Busy. He pops an eyebrow eager. You know all the... You know it's all over the Trivid, right? They found the Emerald City Ripper dead at some asylum in Snohomish. Butcher that. Of all places! Turns out he'd been masquerading as the head administrator or something. They found him dead from some sort of vigilante attack. You wouldn't happen to know anything about that, would you? Why, Mr. Dresden! I have no idea what you mean. That's what I thought. Well, no one can say he didn't have it coming, am I right? That was a double negative. So, the big question. What about your... Now that the Ripper's dead, you're going to collect? Alright. Dead man switch. Almost forgot about that. God, come on. How do you collect? I was told I need a secure line to call the number Sam gave me. Can't use my comm link. Lone Star's emergency response team set up a secure phone line right here to coordinate their efforts. I can authorize you to use it. Thanks, Dresden. Don't mention it. Take care, Archangel. And then there's you.
I heard the Universal Brotherhood was getting shot up on the police scanner. Knew it had to be you. Did you get her?
Did you doubt I would?
Not for a minute.
I guess that concludes the story of Archangel TJ and the Dead Man Switch, huh? You know, I've been thinking. Maybe you should stay in Seattle a while. There's plenty of ways folks like us can get into trouble here. You only skimmed the surface. I heard Mitsuhama's looking for a team and they specifically wanted a woman. No idea what that's about. And I just got word that something's going on at Crater Lake. The Tears got it on total lockdown, no fly zone, the whole thing. There could be something in it for us, if we poke around. And there's always the Orc Underground. Haven't seen that yet, have you? I got plenty of friends who are who are good for a job. I'll think about it, Jake. You do that. If you want to find me, I'll be at McCracken's later. Got a taste for some seafood. Take it easy, chummer. Call the law firm, finish the job. You tap in the phone number Sam's lawyer gave you a few days ago. Gave you days ago? The phone rings 7 times before someone finally answers. The image of the lawyer on the other end of the vid phone is noticeably different from the one you saw a few days ago. Noise in the background sounds like it's coming from a bar. Yeah? Oh, hey, it's you. Archangel TJ, right? So, got Sam killers, huh? Yeah, I got Sam's... What the hell is going on? It's a little complicated. I'll just slot Sam's video for you. Right on. Hey, buddy, looking good, looking good! If you're calling this number, that means the job is done, right? Congratulations, amigo. I knew you'd do it. You were always the dependable one. More than me, anyway. I just want to say thank you for whatever you did. It means a lot. Not even knowing what you did, it still means a lot. Because I know you did something. You know what I mean? I know you made it right. Somehow. You're the only one. The only one. Whoever tried to help me. Ever. Except my sister. She tried. More than once. She tried. Never let her, though. Never let her in. I regret that. A lot. Did I ever tell you about her, buddy? We're twins. We're twins, I guess. You still twin after one of you dies? I don't know. Doesn't matter, I guess. God. Listen, do me a favor, will you? If you talk to her, her name is Jessica. Tell her I'm sorry, okay? For everything. She'll know what for. She's Catholic, so forgive me. I need her to forgive me. Just tell her I love her. Anyway, you need to get paid, which would be great except for one thing. I got nothing. Never did. You know how it is, right? Sorry, but hey, thanks again for giving it crap. Seriously, I appreciate it. So all that, and I am still not getting paid. Tell you what, if you feel sore about it, look into my family background a bit. There's gotta be people with money in there somewhere. Maybe one can throw you a few bucks. Take care, amigo. See you in hell. So, what do you say? Thank you. He just said thank you. Oh my god! The Emerald City Ripper killings are sensationalized for several weeks. Lurid reports focus on the killer masquerading as the administrator of Mercy Mental Hospital. Soon after, pop singer Marina Mercurial is cast as the lead in Dr. Ripper, a private thriller about a reporter who goes undercover as a mental patient to uncover a serial killer. Seattle Newsnet reports a shootout at a chapter house of the Universal Brotherhood. Witnesses claim that a gang of religious fanatics stormed the building for unknown reasons but committed suicide before they could be captured. All mention of insect spirits, James Celestrian III, or Shadowrunners are kept out of the news. 1 year later, the city of Chicago declares a quarantine area between Lake Michigan and the Des Plaines River. Officially, the Chicago Containment Zone is established to fight an outbreak of an infectious virus, but an infestation of insect spirits is suspected by those who know. A mature form of Project Aegis, called Fabs 3, is eventually deployed to remove the bug threat from Chicago. The Watts family name has since been lost to the shadows. Oh my god. I actually beat one! Holy shit! Ha ha! Oh my god, I'm so happy right now! You have no idea how happy I am right now! The next one should definitely be me finishing the Dragonfall expansion. And then when I get the chance, it's on to Hong Kong. Oh my god, I did it. I did it! I'm so happy right now, you have no idea. Oh my god, oh my god, oh my god, oh my god! Oh. I want to thank everybody who sat through this. I'm pretty sure a lot of you were screaming at the screen telling me I'm a fucking idiot, right? Because I've been doing that to myself a lot. Oh my god. Is there something... I'm so glad I can fast forward through these credits. This would be a... This would take a while if I couldn't. Thank you, Harebrained Schemes, for that one. And definitely thank you, Harebrained Schemes, for this game! This! Shadowrun Returns, this game, Dragonfall, Hong Kong, this entire franchise has been, as far as I'm concerned, a very triumphant return to the shadows. And just thank you so much for making this game. Thank you so much. Oh, jeez. And for those of you who have enjoyed this and want to check it out, Shadowrun Returns is on Steam right now. I don't know entirely the price, but yeah, definitely go check this out. Go get Dragonfall, because that's the one I'll be finishing up next. Go get Hong Kong. That's the most recent one that came out, because this is fucking awesome. Oh, it's just the right mix of story and tactics. It makes you think before you just go off shot. I know I just clicked things that sounded funny just to find out what the fucking reaction was. But like with Gino, I had to do that 2 or 3 times because I could not I knew there was a way to save the guy. And I could not for the life of me remember what it was. So I was just clicking all hell. Reload. Okay. This one? No. Reload. Okay. I'm a human. I make mistakes. Okay. Let's just put it like that. Oh my god. And this game was Shadowrun was initially a tabletop game to be played by D&D enthusiasts. Or just people who love tabletop games, because I can't say D&D enthusiasts, just D&D enthusiasts, because there are people who don't like D&D but still play tabletop games. Oh god, it's... That was just amazing. It was. And it shows me the good thing about specialization. Because if you don't specialize in something, you just go all willy-nilly, oh, I'm gonna do this one and this and this. You can't be a jack of all trades. You're the same. A jack of all trades, master of none. You might as well say, I'm fucked. Reason being, Lady Grey is technically a jack of all trades, even though I kind of have her specializing in guns. It's not gonna be a fun thing when I go back to that, because where I am, it's not fun. And just, I can only hope that I can finish that damn mission. Get rid of Fireween and let it all be done and over with, because one, want to get it finished. Two, I want to get Hong Kong. I want to go to China. Well, actually, Hong Kong is its own country, but it was initially part of China before the English took it over and gave it back. Just please. I want Hong Kong. I really want Hong Kong. But, like I said, I'm going to finish Dragonfall before getting to that one. Hopefully it won't be too hard, and we can see how near impossible it is to kill a dragon. Because, good lord, even in the original Sega Genesis SNES version, it could not have been easy to kill the dragon. At least I think you fight a dragon at some point. Either way, dragons, not something to be trifled with. I gotta make sure I have the best equipment. I gotta make sure I am prepared for all of this. Because if I'm not prepared, then I'm screwed. There's gonna be no way to kill Fireween.
Good lord, how long are these credits? I'm running out of things to say. But either way, this game made me think, and it punished you for your mistakes. Which is, quite frankly, what a lot of tactics-type games should be doing. Now, I can't say much for, like, some of the Fire Emblem games, as I have only mostly played the first one on the original Game Boy Advance. But nothing else. XCOM. XCOM can be very punishing if you don't know what you're doing. You need to think. Yeah, you don't know what the enemy is going to do, but you need to come up with some sort of strategy. I know I kind in the whole playthrough, it was probably just me going willy-nilly, seeing the enemy, and going, oh, now I need to think of something, because the enemy's right fucking there. And just, I could probably fit back and be done with that. I could. Okay then. I just wasted how much time talking? Either way, that was Shadowrun Dead Man's Switch. Do I have another scenario after beating that? No, I do not. Okay. Okay, that was the Dead Man's Switch scenario of Shadowrun Returns. The next time you see Shadowrun, it'll be me finishing up Dragonfall. And hopefully, I will be able to get Hong Kong at some point, because I so fucking want to play that one. I love Asia. In it, I am fascinated by the culture of a lot of the Asian countries. And it's just... I want to do it. At some point, I will do it. Until then, this is the Gamer Girl, signing off. Thank you so much for staying with me for this whole playthrough. It means a lot as a first-time YouTuber. This is the first game, the first playthrough I finished on this channel. So, catch you in the next one. Signing off.